Good morning, guys. Welcome to another Clibbery Walk. We're on tour today. It's a bonus episode, walking up the Brown Clee. We're starting on the Tugford Road from Clibbery North. I'll put a map at the end of the video so anybody who wants to follow it can. It's a relatively short walk at 2.6 miles. However, there's an awful lot of ascent. So let's get going. Slog our way up this hill. Coming up on a gateway on our left hand side, that's where we start the climb. It's been an awful long time since I did this walk. So far the trail's very well trodden. And I'm expecting it to be that way all the way to the top. It's already steep and we're about 50 yards out of the car park. It's going to be cool. The path's bent round to the left now. Still going up. Quite a steep rate. But it's only 1.3 miles from the car park to the summit. So it's going to be very steep. Reminds me of the old messing about in the mountains days 20 plus years ago. Still, never mind. Keep on going. And would you look at that, it already feels like we're on top of the world. Just had a check of the map and the path is heading at an angle across the hill to meet up with that forestry up there. There's a sign at the bottom that says that there's forestry operations in progress at the moment, so just got to be very careful. Shouldn't be an issue though. Keep on plugging away. Got a bench, a bit too early in the walk to sit down. Dorothy Mary Cobb loved this place. When we turn round, we can absolutely see why. It's a lady of impeccable taste. Still climbing up the hill, a bit more gently now. Past another bench about 150 metres back. It's very humid today, very little wind, feels kind of hot and sweaty. Never mind, we'll get there. I know puffing and panting on YouTube videos is not the done thing, but I'm not prepared, well, I'm not scared to admit that this is a bit of a slog. Never mind, we'll keep cracking on. Just had a quick check of the map. We're coming up to the edge of the forestry now. In about 100-150 metres, the path turns right up the hill through the forestry. I'll keep an eye peeled for that. The excellent View Ranger app on my phone is operating, showing me real-time positioning, so I know exactly where I am. Very useful for navigating, but no substitute for having good map and compass skills. So we've been on this road for about 100 metres and I think this coming up might be our path. So here we go. Mr. Squirrel there, hiding behind the tree. Big nut in his mouth, bless him. We're heading up this dirt track. Somebody's been having a go at building a Gruffalo house. I used to do that with my lad when he was little. I had hoped to bring my little dog Olive on this walk today, but bless her, she's Romanian or Bosnian, we're not quite sure. She's got a very, very thick coat, and she would have struggled with the warmth today, so sadly I made the decision to leave her at home. I'm not going to be gone for more than about 3 or 4 hours, so she'll be all right, but it'd be lovely to have her here, but I don't want to risk her getting overheated. It's just not worth it. Anyway, we are bending round here. So the path is zigzagging up the hill. It doesn't feel too steep, but when you look back at it, it looks very steep. I suppose that's a good thing, better than the other way round. Absolutely beautiful, deep dark woodlands. And just got to a rocky bit of the path. Just be careful where you tread. The rocks can be slippery. We've got to watch those ankles and knees. But it's not too bad. Just had a look at the map. I'm about a third of the way through the woodland. I'll take that. This is a good sign. Up behind me I can see daylight through the trees. So, not too far to go till we exit the woodland. The psychology of walking up a big hill. A chap I know called Russell Dry asked me about it. You just take it gently. And when you're out of puff, you stop. You get your breath back and you go again and just keep doing that and you will conquer that hill. This is the only way I can work out of doing it sensibly. I'm no athlete. Reasonable level of fitness, reasonable level of stamina, but there's no way I could contemplate walking up this hill without a few breaks, and I wouldn't pretend to do so. I tend to check the map or do a bit of filming, that kind of thing. Yeah, so that's the way I do things. Incredible old tree. So I've just had a quick check of the map, and we're in a point where we change from coniferous woodland to deciduous. So here's our deciduous wood in front of us, much more open. This will be full of wildlife, whereas the coniferous woodland is dark, dank. You only tend to get a lot of wildlife traveling the paths because there's oak and birch lining them and there's a bit more light. It's beautiful up here. I haven't been up here for a very long time. Very handy way marker there, pointing us straight up through those trees. Oddly enough, Scots pine in the deciduous woodland. Fair play. This woodland reminds me of the woods that Gordon and I walked through on the last day of the Great Glen Way early part of October. Absolutely beautiful. The ground's flattened out quite a lot. And before long, we're going to pop out onto the open hillside and then go up to, I think it's Abdon Berth, and then onto the top. I better check the facts on that one. Gotta be right. interestingly enough, the way marker pointing us up here takes us on a path which is marked on the Ordnance Survey, but it's not the public footpath. It actually cuts a good chunk off for us. So what I'm looking for on the forest floor to guide me are footprints and signs that this is fairly frequently walked. So we've got a mountain bike tire mark there. You get up to wet bits, there'll be footprints and they'll tell me that I'm on the right track. Yeah, it was Abdenberth. Looking at this, I got about another 200 or 300 meters of this woodland and then out onto the hillside. It really is a very pleasant walk. I'll have to bring Tom up here one of the days. Just about spot on. Good introduction to hill walking, I reckon. Right, guys, this looks like the edge of the woodland. The path scrambles up that gully. Watch your footing. Remember those knees and ankles. It's a long way down from here with a twisted ankle. Don't want that happening. Just met this chap called Paul, absolutely lovely fella. He's doing a recce for a walk tomorrow with some friends. Heading the same direction as me. And it's very nice to meet you. Fair play. Hope to meet you again sometime. So we've emerged from the woodland into an area of broken ground. You see Paul making his way up there. The ground looks like spoil heap from mining and quarrying in the past. Beautiful nonetheless. The sun's come out for us, so I'm glad I got my sun hat on, and we're gonna amble on up to the top, and once we're there, find somewhere to sit down, have my pasty, and then do a time lapse because the clouds today are spectacular. You can see the path ascending in front of us. Round to the left, it's fairly well trodden. It might be worth, if you're coming up here, bring some insect repellent, because there are plenty of wee bitey things out today. We've got over there some of the ruined buildings. I've got a picture of that on my office wall, taken about 25 years ago. So I've just noticed you've got the ruins on the left-hand side of the frame. Towards the middle, you've got the Wrekin in the far distance by Telford. I walked up that late summer last year with Gordy at the start of our training for the Great Glenway. And there you can see what we've just come up. Woodlands in the distance. And the whole world at our feet. The far distance over there, you can see Aberley Clock Tower. There's a lake here. Some idiots left half a roll mat. I'll take that down with me. Feels like you're on top of the world. With the radio masts there, just to the left of them is the plaque with the directions to all the hills. I'm not quite sure what you call them. But we're heading up that way. Here's our way marker. So where we are is part of the Shropshire Way main route, and the way marker points us up this road. I'm not sure whether or not it's nice to be walking on tarmac again, but we'll see. I'm just going to check the map to make sure I know whether I'm varying off my route or not.
We're all good. The route takes us along this bit of tarmac and up to the summit. Now, if you're of a wild camping persuasion, there's plenty of places up here to hide yourself away for a quick overnighter. Something I'd love to do more, but with two dogs, the cost of kennelling is quite a lot, so I tend to go out once or twice a year, maximum.
I'm surprised how much water there is up here. It's no bad thing. Up to the cattle grid we go. Radio masts. More compounds. We're heading up here to a cattle grid. It's absolutely beautiful up here. What a wonderful day. I was expecting all sorts of rain and horribleness because I booked the day off, but now it's all good. So we're very nearly at the top now. The road's bearing round to the triangulation point and the top of the hill. It's absolutely beautiful up here. That's a very good use of a day off work. Guys, you see the top? It's not been difficult really. It's not technically demanding, it's just been a nice plod. And I'd recommend this walk to anybody. We're probably a half hour drive from Clibbury here. But it's a pleasant one through Stotterston and Clibbury North. So all in all, having an incredibly enjoyable time. So this is the view we've had behind us, all of the way up. You can see we're right up at the summit now, just below the old thing there. And this is incredible. Walk up here. And you've got what seems like the whole of Shropshire laid out in front of you, and Herefordshire and Powys. Absolutely incredible. Absolutely incredible. There you go, Ordnance Survey benchmark S4545. Bye. If you want to see the video, it's on Clibbury Walks.
Clibbury Walks?
Yeah. It'll be up tomorrow, probably. Right. Very nice to meet you. Yeah. There we go. That tells us what all the hills and features are in front of us. Now my job for the next half hour is to find somewhere nice to sit down, have my lunch, and do a nice time lapse of the clouds rolling across the sky. Just sitting down, chilling, looking at the view, having a fantastic lunch. We look down there, got Nordy Ring. This is a shout out to you, Alan. Thanks for watching my videos, buddy. Have to have a catch up when all this COVID-19 business is done. And back round to Titterston Clee. Well, that's lunchtime done. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to descend back down to the car, exactly the same route that we came up, only backwards. And to do that, we're going to hit hyperspeed.
Yeah, it sounds dramatic, but that's actually what GoPro call it. I will speak to you again when I get back to the car. Hope you've enjoyed the video, guys.
Here we are back at the trig point, and it's time to hit the accelerator. So here I am back at the van, blazing sunshine, quite a quick descent. I think I came down in about 25 minutes. It's a beautiful walk, and I hope you guys have enjoyed watching Clibbury Walks on Tour. This is what's going to be happening a bit more in the future. I've walked most of the footpaths around Clibbury now. So rather than just putting out repetitive stuff, we're going to go and do some interesting stuff. Never much more than about 4 or 5 miles in duration, and really beautiful out of the way places. Thanks for coming along on this journey with me. Thank you for all your support. And if you like the content, please click like and subscribe. Thank you. Goodbye.